Okay, thank you very much for invitation. So basically I will speak a bit about like a survey about rationality for conic bundles for threefolds and some applications for quartic double solid, and you may consider my talk as like a warm up for the colloquium talk of Claire Voisin talk. Okay, so let's consider X to be threefold. And let S to be some rational surface. And we suppose that there exists a surjective map such that generic fiber is a conic. Okay, so basically generic fiber is a conic. So then we may try to find a good model for this conic bundle, so namely by good model, so there exists a commutative diagram. So here I don't assume that threefold or surface is like smooth, but we can disangularize them, and then we can slightly change the base. So there exists a birational transformation such that two birational maps, say alpha beta, so alpha beta birational. Such that this conic bundle, it's called has some nice properties, which is called standard. So this is pi prime, pi. So this is a so-called standard conic bundle. And by standard means, so that several properties satisfy. So first of all, this threefold and this surface are both smooth. And that relative Picard group of X prime over S prime is 1. Okay, we always can do this. And then once this is done, so we can introduce a discriminant divisor. So basically this delta prime is a discriminant curve. So, and in this case, this condition implies that this curve has a simple normal crossing divisor. So we have points like this. And over smooth points, we have conic fibers of this map by prime inverse. It looks like two rational curves, two copies of P1s transversally intersecting in one point. And over the singular points, it's going to be like a double P1s. Yeah? So we have this picture. And then it's so the threefold X prime, X and X primes are rationally connected. So it's natural to basically ask the question when this X prime is rational in terms of discriminant curve and other data. So there's actually old conjecture about rationality of this, which is more than 100 years. It's due to Cantor, and I think it's 1. So basically, it says that if X is rational, so what rationality means? Rationality means that there exists a birational map, say, from X prime to P3. So this definition, yeah, birational. But Cantor's conjecture said that all conics, all fibers of this map, of this conic bundle, are mapped to conics here. So this is a very strong restriction, such that of a general image of general fiber of this pi prime is a conic in P3. Okay. Okay, so this is more or less like one direction. So rationality implies some property, but this is still open, but I will speak about this in a bit later. Okay, in the first more or less abstraction to rationality is due to Clemens and Griffiths. Is basically if you have to have this discriminant curve and the conic bundle induce a double cover of this curve. Yeah. Which is ramified only at this singular point. So this is a 2-to-1 cover. I don't know, ramified in singular points. Of delta prime. And this, using this way, you can correspond to this double cover in this curve, generalized prim variety of this double cover. And in this case, it's going to be intermediate Jacobian of our threefold. It's a principally polarized varieties. And so then, this splits as a Griffiths component. So basically, if we can prove that this splits as a polarized abelian variety is a direct sum of Jacobians of curves, sum of Jacobians of curves, and from I to 1 to R, and then the rest. And the rest usually called the Griffiths component of X prime. Yeah.
Why don't you give C stars?
I think that's only for rational surface.
Everything assumed to be surface, assumed to be rational, threefold rationally connected, and we have the stability condition because it's coming from 2-to-1.
Is the curve singular?
Curves may be singular, but
how do we avoid C star?
It's not just the curve. This is the curve. Discriminant curve of a conic bundle, which is
minimal
in this case. Okay. So basically then we have this theorem, which if this component is not zero, it's a birational invariant, then X prime is not rational. And this can be actually effectively applied in many cases. So for example, it's an application. Just give you an example. I don't know if you take, say, X prime to be general divisor. Okay, just smooth, not general. You may assume smooth divisor of by degree 2m in P2 cross P2, then projection to the second factor, it's a conic bundle. And so if m in this case is bigger or equal than 2, if m is 1, then this guy is rational, but if m is bigger or equal than 2, then one can prove that this guy is not rational. This guy is not zero, so this is not rational. So in every case, one more or less can do this. But then, but this is not a, so it's a necessary condition, but it's not sufficient condition. So there exist conic bundles with trivial Griffiths component and such that it's non-rational anyway. So basically, this condition being non-zero is not sufficient condition for rationality in general. For non-rationality. Okay, no, other way around. Zero is not sufficient for rationality. And there are many ways how to show examples like this, but let me go to the next theorem, which is slightly complementary to this, which is due to Sarkisov. So if we consider, so in our assumption, when this conic bundle is standard, if we consider this linear system, canonical divisor of a surface, multiplied by, say, 4, so this is, should be something negative. Yeah, surface is rational, so this is a relatively negative divisor. And then if you add this criminal curve, and you look on this linear system, yeah, like, for example, in this case, if M is bigger than 3, bigger or equal than 3, but you basically compute the degree of discriminant curve is bigger, is going to be bigger or equal than 6, so it's going to be, bigger or equal, maybe bigger or equal than 4. So anyway, you compute, and in many cases, you can explicitly compute that this linear system is not empty. So it contains a curve. So if this happens, then this implies that X prime is, put it this way, very non-rational. And in the following sense, so if you have birational transformation of X prime to some Mori fiber space, threefold, so let it be new Mori fiber space. So it may be the conic bundle, it may be the Alpetsu-Fire vibration, or it may be Fano threefold with terminal Q factorial singularity and Picard group Z. So in this case, Z is a point. So one of the three cases. Then we have that Z is a surface, so it's a conic bundle. So this, and there exists commutative diagram, and we have commutative diagram like this. So basically, it means it's a equivalent conic bundle. You just change the base and you change the threefold, so the diagram commutes. So this is a modern definition. This is what's called birational rigidity. So in general, it's kind of give you stronger result than this, and it's applicable in many cases. And one can use this theorem to cook up examples with a conic bundle with trivial intermediate Jacobian, not just Griffith's component, but the whole Jacobian is trivial, and such that this condition is satisfied. So let's do this. Okay, let's do this. So for example, one can take P2, and one can take a, for example, elliptic curve, cubic curve, smooth. And if you pick up, three N points on this curve, let's call it P1, P3, N, and we can blow up P2 in this points. So just a blow up of this point in this points. So then this proper transform of this curve, it belongs to anti-canonical divisor. So in general, if these points are taken sufficiently general, it is going to be the unique curve there. But if you take them slightly less general, so if basically they form M torsion. So put it this way, if you put extra conditions, some of these points on this curve minus basically H NH restricted to C3, where H is a hyperplane. Hyperplane. If this divisor D is M-torsion, it's extra condition. Then M's multiple of this curve is actually going to be a pencil. Pencil of elliptic curves, free pencil. Okay. No. I'm lying. So it should be 9 points. N is three. N is three. It's going to be pencil. So you have this map, P1, and this curve. So it's elliptic vibration. And this curve in anti-canonical divisor is going to be M's multiple fiber of this vibration. Basically, if you put M C3, it's going to be rationally equivalent to this general fiber of this, I don't know, G. Okay. Good. And then basically what you can take this curve, you can take general fiber. If you take Z to be general fiber of this elliptic vibration, then it's elliptic curve. And you can take any double cover of this curve unramified, and you can use this curve as a discriminant curve. So you can take any unramified 2-to-1 cover of this curve. So it's smooth elliptic curve. And then using this pair, this double cover, and this surface S, there's a theorem that you can construct a conic bundle with this ramification curve and with this double cover. So basically there exists some conic bundle with this data. And then if you want to check this condition, what this condition means, if you want Sarkisov condition to be satisfied, it's equivalent to say 4 times C3 tilde plus fiber, but fiber is MC3. It should be not empty. So if M is bigger or equal than 4, this condition automatically done. So if. So, yeah, of course. Yeah. Thank you. Yeah. So then this condition automatically satisfied. So this threefold is, this conic bundle going to be non-rational. Non-rational and actually rationally rigid. Yeah. Okay. But on the other hand, the primion of this map, it's trivial. So this more or less show that these two conditions are kind of independent. This condition and this condition. So it's independent. Okay. And let me erase this. Another invariant for abstraction for non-rationality. So again, if we have this conic bundle with discriminant curve, we can take the R to be the number of connected components of the discriminant curve. Delta prime. And then third, two torsions in the third cohomology group of the threefolds is going to be basically Z2 in the number of connected components minus 1. So basically means this was used by Artin and Mumford to construct examples, many examples of, okay, one example, conic bundle which which is not rational, not even stably rational because of this. And probably this example appear in the talk of Claire Wasm later this week. Okay, so basically that's Artin Mumford. In Artin Mumford case, it's more or less similar case here. So we have S prime is P2. S, put it this way, S is P2. Remember, we had this diagram. I will go back to this in a second. They consider example, they start with conic bundle SSP2 and discriminant curve of the conic bundle. It's a union of two elliptic curve intersecting in points C1, C2. But in this case, the threefold X has nine singular points which are lying over this singular points of the discriminant curve, intersection of these two cubic curves. So X is singular. Singular over basically singular points of discriminant curve. So then what you can do, how you can construct the standard model, basically you blow up these nine points and then you do flops. You blow up singular points here and you do flops on the proper transform of this conics here. And once you do this, you have conic bundle over the proper transform of this curve, so they split, and you have exactly two connected components. So torsion, two torsion subgroup of the Selke homology group is just Z2. So it's non-rational. Okay. So this more or less, more or less like three famous approaches.
For this?
Yes,
there's this expression of the
Artin-Mumford
invariant.
But this is an Artin-Mumford paper.
They say that it is exactly the number of...
Yeah. No, the two torsion subgroup of this is Z2 to the... Okay, and now, so this is was more or less about non-rationality. And if you want to ask, okay, what's about rationality? And then it's actually, we don't know much, but suppose we want to, okay, let's just ask a question. You fix a conic bundle, suppose it's standard, which is not necessary, but anyway, suppose, and you want to prove it's rational. So we had a lot of abstraction, but let's now fix this standard conic bundle. Standard conic bundle. Everything smooth, good. And so we saw several abstractions. Maybe, since Janusz is in the room, I should mention that there is a reduction characteristic P method due to Janusz Kohler that given another way proving non-rationality. So other methods, other abstractions to rationality, it's a characteristic P reduction due to Kohler. And the degeneration technique, also due to Kohler and the degeneration
technique.
No, because it's criteria. It's not an abstraction. I mean, this is conjectural criteria. I will go to this.
14 degrees seems to be checked.
No, I'll go to this. Okay. I'll go to this. I slightly go to this. Because in order to get a criteria in English language, criteria means sufficient condition. In Russian language, criteria means if and only if. So if I... No, this is true. So in order to give criteria, really criteria, I need first to say something about rationality. So far, I only was talking about non-rationality, rationality, and then we'll try to match these things together. So basically, this is the exercise. Suppose you ask a question, how to prove rationality of X prime, of a conic bundle? So again, S prime is a rational surface. Yeah. Since it's supposed to be sort of mixture of conference in a school, I mean, this is a question to everyone. Any ideas? Thank you, Sasha. Thank you. Okay. But any just.
So use Shakurov's theorem.
No, 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 wait. No, just no theorems. It's just an idea. Just an idea. Suppose someone give you threefold, fibered into conics explicitly, and ask, okay, let's try to. It looks like it's rational. Let's try to prove that it is.
Does it have a rational section?
Yes, if you can do this. Suppose there are no rational sections. Good. Suppose there is no rational. Yeah. Actually, this is a warm answer. So if you take generic fiber, basically of this guy, it's a conic in P2 over this field, yeah, field of rational functions on S prime, yeah. So if conic has a point, it's irrational, but it's kind of stronger than we need. It means basically you can have a map to P3 more or less, like over the base. So it's much stronger than we need, much stronger. But this is the first step in the right direction.
Ask math overflow.
Well, maybe half of math overflow participants in this room. Okay, anyway. So what you can do, you can basically try to use what Bert says, but in dimension one higher. So basically you can fiber this surface by rational curves and then restrict over to generic fiber. So namely, you try to find a pencil, let me call it like L, of rational curves. Not necessarily free from base points, but ideally if it's free from base points. And then what do you have? You basically, so this pencil gives you the map. On S, of course, on S. Pencil on the surface. On the surface. You fiber surface by rational curves. And then this gives you the map S prime to P1. And you restrict everything to generic fiber of this map. Let it be H, map. You just restrict everything. And what do you have? I mean, then you have if you denote this field of rational function, let's denote it like K, this field. And then you take a generic fiber, and then your threefold over this field, it's basically you becomes a surface, a rationally connected surface over this field. Some surface over this field. Since generic element here is rational, it's going to be P1. So then the surface S prime over this field is just P1. Because it's a fibered by rational curves. We assume pencil of rational curves, yeah? Okay, so what is this? This is a conic bundle of a non-closed field, which is fibered, conic bundle of a non-closed field. It's smooth because this guy was smooth. So it has several singular fibers. And what's the number of singular fibers of this conic bundle? So this is conic bundle. And the number of singular fibers, it's exactly the number of intersection point of generic curve here with a discriminant curve. You take L to be generic curve here, and you take intersection, and it's exactly going to be singular fibers. Called it R, so it's going to be this R singular fibers. Okay, and then you say, okay, maybe we can prove that this surface is rational over this base field, and if we're done, we're done. But of course, it's much stronger than rationality of X prime. It means rationality over this base. Unfortunately, it usually doesn't work. And there's actually exact statement when it works and when it doesn't work. So you look. So there's a theorem, which is due to Iskovskich, which basically said that if K square, let's put it this way, if R is bigger or equal. So anyway, we need to take k square of this. So what is k square of this? Is 8 k square of the surface. is 8 minus r, how many singular points we have. So if this guy is bigger or equal than 5, then this surface is non-rational over the base field.
Enough pencil, and
you
so you don't send
double lines like this. Well, some pencil of rational. I don't know. We try to find it.
So you said the opposite vibration.
No, no, no. Wait. This is a conic bundle over the non-closed field. So, for example, if r is bigger than 8, it's definitely not. But not the opposite vibration. So what does it mean? It means that if r is bigger than 4. Sorry. Not bigger equal than 5. Strictly bigger than 5. If r is bigger than 3, then this trick is not applicable. And in fact, the trick, it's maybe our threefold is rational, but we cannot prove it this way. And moreover,
maybe less than 5 you walked.
Sorry. Okay, put it this way. Bigger than 5, x is rational, if and only if. X is rational. So if degree bigger equal than 5, bigger equal than 5, if and only if the surface is rational over the base field. It's a criterion in the Russian sense. So, so it means that if number of singular points bigger than 3, trick doesn't work, but maybe threefold is rational. If number of singular fibers less than equal than 3, trick works, and it is rational. Okay. And then you say, okay, what's next? Suppose it doesn't work. So, but the problem is that you have to go through all. So what you first do? You first do, you take these pencils to be like free pencils, if you can. And the second, if it doesn't, you take non-free pencils. And but in general, you may think maybe you can, let's restrict everything on the only for free pencils, then it's much easier. If pencil has no base points, it's just easier to compute. Actually, I cheated a bit. If base point, when I said it's intersection, so if some base point of this pencil sort of sits inside the discriminant curve, you have to take this into account. So it's basically, I need to assume somewhere here that this pencil has no base points. But we always can do this, because if it has base points, we can blow them up, and we can find a different model. And that's it. And then this gives leads Iskovskich to a conjecture. So the conjecture basically says that this trick always works for some pencils. Okay, so this is a conjecture due to Iskovskich. So that basically he said that it's x prime is rational if and only if. So she is like really if and only if. One of the following, one of the two things is true. One of two cases hold. First, it's more or less, you can say that this trick is true if you change the base a bit. So there exists a birational map. You change the base slightly. So basically, you blow up the base a bit. So such that this is also standard conic bundle. Such that this is also standard conic bundle. And on this surface, there exists a pencil without base points. There exists L. To this, say double prime pencil of rational curves without base points, no base points, such that intersection of generic element of this pencil with discriminant curve is less than equal than 3. So it basically means after blowing up some number of points on the base, on the surface, you can find, you can use this trick with non-closed field and it's going to work. Or there's a second case. There's a second case when it's basically doesn't work. Because Iskovskich encountered one case when it doesn't work. So he put it as an exception. Yeah. At least he couldn't prove it doesn't work. So maybe it actually works, but anyway. So second case was like this. You take P3. Okay, put it this way. Let me put this diagram star. This diagram star exists for very special conic bundle. For the case when X double prime is a blow up of P3, so it's irrational, in the curve Z, curve of degree 7, smooth curve, but anyways, degree 7, genus 5. And if you take this curve, you can take cubic surfaces passing through these curves. An intersection of two cubic surfaces is going to be some curve of degree 9, but it contains this guy, so it splits as this curve and the conic, so it gives you the conic bundle. So basically it means that this map pi prime is given by cubic surfaces in P3 passing through this curve, given by cubic surfaces. Basically passing through this curve. So it's very explicit. So this is the same conic bundle, almost the same. I mean, it's the discriminant curve going to be the curve of degree 5 in P2. And S prime, S double prime, in this case, is just P2. But its theta characteristic is different from the cubic threefold. So it's very similar conic bundle to the conic bundle that arises on the cubic threefold, but double cover is slightly different. Yeah. So it is rational by construction. And in this case, it's very hard to find a pencil like this. Maybe it exists, but Iskovsky couldn't find it. So he conjectured that either this case or this case happen. Okay. Good. And then basically he proved that this conjecture is true if you assume original counter-conjecture, which I erased already, so that every rational conic bundle can be mapped to P3 in a way that every conic mapped to really a conic in P3. So he proved that these two conjectures are equivalent, which is already quite surprising. If you try to prove this kind of stuff, one way, how can you proceed? So first of all, you definitely know that if your discriminant curve is big enough, I mean, you can apply Sarkisov theorem, so it's non-rational and rigid, so it's not applicable here. So it's basically, you need to prove only one direction of this conjecture, because second direction is proved already here on this blackboard. And then if your discriminant curve is small enough, you can try to apply minimal model program to this pair. So basically, you change the base a bit, you contract something, then you try to change the threefold a bit and keep doing this. The only problem is that minimal model program gives you singularity. So it completely destroys the smoothness and standard model. But at some point, the good thing about this, at some point you can get to the surface with Picard group Z. But unfortunately, a priori, it's supposed to be with log terminal singularities. And then they may form, and they form actually, infinitely many families, and you don't know what to do with this. But then in every case, Iskovsky checked, this surface with Picard group Z had actually dual singularities, and not just dual, AN. And then he conjectured that this is always true. And if it's always true that such dual Delpeza with AN singularities, they form a bounded family. I mean, just very short list. And you go through the list, and if your discriminant curve is small, I mean, you get immediate bound for example, for its arithmetic genus. And this gives you a bound for arithmetic genus here, if this conjecture is true. So he conjectured that the base of this conic bundle, which appears as an output of the minimal model program, always has dual singularities. He conjectured it's always dual. And using this conjecture, he proved that this conjecture and counter-conjecture, because they're equivalent, holds under additional assumption that arithmetic genus of delta of this discriminant curve is bigger or equal than 18. Yeah, but then this conjecture about the conic bundle was open for many years. And then his student, Yuri Prokhorov, who is not here, he worked a lot with Moria on basically description of all possible singularity that appears in the conic bundle, which arise in the minimum modular program when this is terminal Q factorial singularities. And basically, they describe everything, all types of singular fibers. It's like a big work. They basically published like maybe three of papers about this. And as a result of this long work, they proved this conjecture. So if you have a terminal threefold, have a conic bundle, so it's a relative Picard group Z, so it's a Mori fiber space also, then the base has always dual singularities, and to be precise, not just dual, just AN. And so this conjecture is true under this assumption. And so counter conjecture also true. But in general, it's not known. Okay.
Morris and Prokhorov still
in terms of genus? No, they have no genus. Morin Prokhorov's theorem says it's always dual. Base is always dual. But Iskovsky's theorem says that if you know this conjecture, he conjectures it, then you can prove this conjecture under this assumption. And basically, I gave a sketch how to do this. Okay, okay. And more or less a bit earlier before this. Okay, so we have all of these conjectures. All this. And then you may ask a question. Okay, maybe we don't know how to prove them, but maybe we prove them in some special cases. And the first special case was done by Shakurov, who proved all of this conjecture, very special case. So let me tell, look. So we have several conjectures. So let's fix. Okay, I will not use this primes. So it's just standard conic bundle. Standard conic bundle. Conic bundle. We have this many conjectures, and you ask basically, okay, if you want to prove it in the simplest case, what is the simplest case? The simplest case when S is P2, but in this case is kind of known by intermediate Jacobian case. And the second simple, the simplest case is Fn. So when P2 or Fn, then there's a theorem, it's many people in this case, and the Shakurov in this case, so let me just put it Shakurov for simplicity. So it basically says that X is rational if and only if Griffith's component of intermediate Jacobian is not zero, is zero. So in general, we know that this condition is not a sufficient condition for rationality. But remember, in the example I gave, you take P2 and you blow up 9 times. So it's not. But here you don't blow up actually anything, like the smallest thing. So in this case, it is true. So intermediate Jacobian is enough to test and to it's if and only if give you if and only if condition for rationality. Yeah, and immediately using this, Shakurov proved that this theorem. It's rather easy exercise to show if this is true, then this conjecture true in this case. So it's a corollary of this. Corollary. All these conjectures true in this case. All conjectures hold in this case for S Fn. Okay, and but we already know that if we blow up 9 points, this is not true. Also, Shakurov observed, when he proved this, he observed that you can replace, so it basically was observation by Shakurov, that at least in this case, it was another corollary, but it follows from the proof. Corollary like this. If you consider this linear system, so in the Sarkisov case, here it was 4. Here it's 2 slightly, because this canonical divider is negative. So when you do make 2, it means it's kind of weaker, much weaker condition. And then if this linear system is not empty, then X is so more or less this is non-rational. Okay, put it this way. If and only if non-rational, except put it me for simplicity, put it except the cubic threefold case. in cubic threefold, SSP2. No. In the cubic case, discriminant curve is degree 5 on P2. So this is degree 6. So it's empty, but it's non-rational. So if your conic bundle is not fiber square equivalent, like in this diagram, to the conic bundle which arises from the cubic on the cubic threefold for using projection from a line, except only this case, this is if and only if, but Shakurov proved it in this case. In the case of yeah, so it's more or less follows from proof of this corollary. It's just replacement, so it's yeah. And then he thought, okay, maybe we can use this corollary as a conjecture in general. And this is Shakurov's conjecture about conic bundle. So in general, he just conjectured this. Let me just erase this and put here a conjecture, and for any surface. So conjecture of Shakurov. So Shakurov is true for SS FN or P2. Okay, and then Iskovskih a bit later, maybe like 6 years later, proved that this conjecture is equivalent to his conjecture. So it's the same thing. So it's also true, for example, under this assumption. Yeah, you must say. Okay, so good. And so this more or less like a survey, what is known, what is not. But let me just give you some example. You may think it is an exercise for the evening session today. So let's try to prove this conjecture, something in some cases which are not yet covered. And we already know that FN P2 is okay, but we know that if we blow up P2 in 9 points, we have problems. So it's a natural suggestion to blow up less than 9 points. And what you get if you blow up less than 9 points, I mean, you get something, but what is the simplest nice objects if you blow up P2 in less than 9 points? Delpeza surfaces, yeah. So let's just consider the case for Delpeza surfaces. And the special subcases of this. So from now on, let's assume that S, for example, okay, put it this, let me put just a theorem. So it's, okay, in some sense, this is like a remark, but it's actually very easy. It was inspired by email correspondence with Claire Wazan. So basically, Claire asked me some question, and I said, oh, it's easy to do. And Claire mentioned in her paper that I did it, yeah. But and I felt kind of under pressure because of this. I thought, okay, if I did it, I probably have to do it. Okay, and since I was discussing this with some of my friends, so we decided to do it together. It's easier. And so basically me, that's Viktor Przelkovsky, who is sitting somewhere on the back road. It's hard to pronounce his name, so okay. I don't know. Okay, anyway, Przelkovsky, so like this. And Kostya Shramov, yeah. Okay, put it this way. So if S, the same notation, X, S is a standard conic bundle. And if S is Delpeza, smooth Delpeza surface. Then, more or less, we have an analog of theorem of Shakurov, but with few exceptions. Another thing, it's actually work in progress. Yeah. So, because it's going to be not complete, so work in progress. Because we have to... Okay. Then, this Griffith component is zero, if and only if X is rational, except few cases, which we don't know. Except few cases. which I don't want to tell about. So it's a but in particular, we have a corollary of this. I don't want to list all these cases. Corollary of this. If degree of the Delpeche surface is bigger or equal than 4, we have no exceptional cases. No few cases. So it basically means if you blow up P2 in up to 5 points, intermediate Jacobian controls rationality completely. And this is not true if you blow up more than points. And this is, let me just give you a few cases and you see immediately why they're few. So I have 1 hour, yeah? Okay. So let's see how these few cases arise and why this case square big equal than 4 is a really important condition here. Let's just give one example and it's going to be clear how exceptions look like. Just an example. So you have S, so let's violate this case. So we have simplest violation, like a cubic surface in P3, smooth cubic surface in P3. So its case square is 3, so the simplest case. And let's consider discriminant curve to be the, so suppose it belongs to the minus 2 KS. So it's basically intersection of the cubic and a quadric. So it basically means this delta is intersection of a cubic surface with some quadric surface in P3. Yeah? Then, first of all, we expect our threefold to be non-rational by Shakurov criterion. Because we have this condition, 2KS plus delta is just 0, so it's not empty. On the other hand, this curve delta is a trigonal by definition. Trigonal curve. Yeah, because it's quadric, it's P1 cross P1. It's intersected by cubic, so projection to any P1, it gives you the 3-3-1 cover. So from this, let's more or less follow that correspondent premium is a Jacobian of a curve. So it's no. I mean it follows. Yeah, no, it just follows. So intermediate Jacobian, this Griffiths component is zero, but we expect this guy to be non-rational. And a relatively recent paper of Voisin. It implies that if this curve is taken to be very general, that this is non-rational by degeneration technique. So there is a very remark. If delta is very general, then x is non-rational, non-stably rational, but it's non-stably non-rational. Okay, not stably rational, not stably. Rational by Voisin. But Claire used different language, which I'm going to mention in a second.
This is degeneration of the.
Degeneration to Mumford. But let me just. Okay, so this is the exceptions. And now let me. So we have this remark, we have this example, and I have exactly 4 minutes and 40 seconds to talk about what I was supposed to talk about. About this double covers, how this relates to double cover. So let's fix. Okay, now let's consider V to be threefold, which is double cover of P3, ramified on a quartic surface. This quartic surface in P3, 2-1 cover. Yeah. So if this surface is smooth, then this guy is known to be non-rational by the result of Voisin. and also non-birational to the Koenig bundle. So it's very strong, using also its intermediate Jacobian. But let's assume that's a singular surface. But in the simplest case, so suppose it has only ordinary double points. Let's just list them. So we have this P1, PR. Okay, then the first result like this. Okay, if someone asks you, give me example of this guy with many singular points. If I ask for one singular point, you just write down equation. Two, you write down equation. Three, you write down, but with say with six, it's already you need to going to be a bit tricky. Well, that's very simple. I mean, it's an exercise. So we can consider this as so we take a double cover that looks like this. You take some x, y, z, t, and multiply by some cubic polynomial, and add or subtract square. Yeah. If you take equation like this. It has many singular points. Why? Because it's singular where, so this is equation of the quartic. So where x is 0, this is 0, and this is 0, it's singular. Just take partial derivative. How many singular points, if everything is general, have 6 singular points? But this is, of course, special case. Why special case? Because if you look at this, you can cook up a smooth cubic threefold out of this. Yeah? So this is basically decomposition, affine equation of cubic threefold. So this, if you have equation like this, it has 6, and everything is generic. This and this is generic. You have 6 singular points. This R is 6 singular points. But this threefold is actually birational to a cubic surface. It's just projection from a point of a cubic surface. So then V prime is actually birational to the cubic threefold in P3, P4. This projection from a point. And it's actually a bad case. Why, in a way, I mean, it's non-rational. We know by Clemens-Griffiths it's non-rational. But we also know that the class group of V prime in this case is Z2. Because you project from a point, you have seen it's non-factorial. And then, first of all, it's a good thing that you can, with the same, my friends, we prove it's also exercise you can do in the evening today. So if this threefold is not factorial, so it means if class group is not Z, then it's always rational, except this case. Except only one case, except this case. Well, it doesn't matter how many points. Ordinary double points, take care. In particular, from this immediately follows that if its number of singular points bigger or equal than 11, bigger or equal than 11, then it's rational. Because it's always, in the case, it's going to be always non-factorial. In this case, factoriality is a linear condition. It means the singular points impose independent linear condition on the quadrics in P3. In the space of quadrics, it's 10-dimensional, so you have 11 singular points. So what does it mean? It means that if we want to study rationality in this case, we have to study only factorial ones. It's a good thing. It's class group is Z. It's good. It's a Moria fiber space in this case, and number of singular points up to 10. And then we have another theorem, which basically it's corollary of this, but not exactly corollary of this, but the same proof, but much simpler. Corollary is if number of singular points, again ordinary double points, it's less than or equal than 6, then intermediate Jacobian Griffiths component of desingularization is not empty. So it's non-rational. So you have cases 7 singular points, 8, 9, and 10. And 10 singular points is exactly the Artin-Mumford case, more or less. And what Claire did in her paper, that in the case of 7, 8, and 9, she basically showed that we can nicely degenerate to the Artin-Mumford case.
and use so generic one is non-rational. It's stable non-rational. And the case when with seven singular points. So the first case, which is not covered by the theorem, it's exactly this this example. So if you have seven singular points, you pick one of them, project from it. It gives you the conic bundle, but it's not standard conic bundle because six singular points left. You blow up them, like I mentioned, you do flops, and then you have to blow up the base. You blow up the base and six points. What you get cubic surface. So this case is not covered by this result, not covered by intermediate Jacobian, but it's covered by theorem of Clairvoyant and basically degeneration. Yeah, and the other case is probably similar, but only generic case. When it's any non-generic, it's still open. Okay, let me stop. Okay,
questions, comments?
So you mean that because of 7 months, you
know, the progress? No, we don't do this. We do the old technique in bi-rational geometry.
I understand that. Because you said
it's going to be basically like, and this is going to do only one exception, this one for 7 nodes, which is covered by your result in generic case.
What you call the few cases?
Yeah. This is, it's going to be just few cases. It's like few linear, few classes for discriminant. Yeah, few cases.
So maybe if you assume this,
No, I don't think so. I think this. First of all, if this is true, then in quartic case, in this case, this is enough for non-rationality. So this conjecture implies basically that the threefold is non-rational if and only if it's factorial, with one exception of the cubic surface. But this is much stronger. But what you mentioned, I said. I don't think it's going to work.
Why?
If this conjecture, because if you, okay, say.
You intermediate Jacobian at some point, it could become Jacobian of a curve in your modular space.
Theoretically, yes. If you want to construct explicit in all explicit examples, I don't think it's work. Yeah. But it's believed to be not true. Yeah. Mm-hmm. At least it's another conjecture.
Really nice,
yeah.
Any other questions? No, let's finish.